guess who's up next for the IFBA Continental Junior Welterweight Championship? Anami, fresh off a win over Christy Martin. And Dora Weber, who has revenge in mind. Weber, 40 years old, 14-5-3, has been fighting for 23 years. And here's the Island Girl.
And arguably the best pound-for-pound fighter in the world today. She beat the women's pound-for-pound champion, Christy Martin. She's also coming off a victory over Denise Moraitis, who you just saw. And she's a creature of emotions, but when she gets into that ring, she is focused on destruction.
Here's the tale of the tape.
You see Weber's age, 40. Anani much younger, same height, pretty much the same weight, same reach. They, of course, they battled before, but Anani is just a ferocious fighter.
She did win over Weber by decision the last time they met. And now we go back upstairs into the ring, and Danny Valdivia.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is our special event of the evening. Junior welterweights, 10 rounds for the vacant IFBA Continental Junior Welterweight Championship. Judges for this Continental title bout, all from the state of Louisiana, from West Monroe, Bruce McDaniels, from New Orleans, Johnny Femia Jr., from Thibodeau, Russell Knocken. Our referee from Richmond, Texas, Barry Yates. And now, the challengers. In the blue corner, wearing blue trunks with white trim, her record 14 wins, 5 losses, 3 draws, 7 of her wins by knockout, at 139 pounds, from Paterson, New Jersey, fighting out of Joe Greer's Boxing Academy, the Destroyer, Dora Weber. And in the red corner, wearing tie-dye colored trunks, undefeated in 14 professional bouts, 7 of her wins by knockout. She recently beat Christy Martin, Christy's first defeat in 9 years, at 135 pounds, from Kansas City, Missouri, Samaya Anani.
Smitty, you saw the Anani Martin fight. Anani said she thought she'd have to knock her out to win a championship. Martin hadn't lost ever, 9 years as a pro fighter, the golden girl of women's boxing. But Anani took it by decision. And was it close?
It was a close fight, but Anani, you know, just, and you'll see in just a second, she is nonstop. You can't hurt her. She's so focused. And although, again, she's a very emotional young lady, the most difficult part for her is leading up to the fight, the interviews, and all the things that go along with boxing. But once she's in the ring, she's unbelievable. And she demonstrated in her last fight against Denise Moraitis, she not only can brawl and punch, but she can box. And that'll spell a lot of trouble for Dora Weber. But Dora has been there, done that for over 20 years. So it's a very compelling matchup.
In the 80s, she would fight 15 rounders. She loves the action. And she's got some revenge in mind because she thought she could beat her the last time they fought. And it was a decision. Anani can fight as a brawler. She can fight as a boxer. She's got many styles. She's very, very smart in the ring. She's a massage therapist, so there are some who say she hurts with her hands and then heals with her hands.
Well, inside the ring, she doesn't do any massaging. She is strictly in the hurt business once the bell rings. I was very impressed with her left jab against Denise Moraitis. You see it there snapping out, and it's a hard left jab, like most all of her punches. When she's inside, she punches to the body, to the head. She'll hit anything that's in front of her.
Weber has power. She has 7 knockouts. Same amount that Anani's got.
Has an identical twin, Cora Weber, that's also had an outstanding, lengthy boxing career. She's like a pioneer of the women's game. Dora Weber and sister Cora.
Cora and Dora. Cora once knocked out an opponent. A month later, she went to face Dora, and they thought they were playing the switcheroo on her. They had to get proof that this was a different person. Cora retired. We hear she wants to come back and fight some more.
Nice right hand by Anani there. You see her go upstairs, downstairs. Weber needs to drop that chin a little bit. Denise Moraitis is in great shape, physically and mentally, when she gets in there. She's She's into yoga and some breathing exercises and meditation and all that. And she really believes that, you know, the mental part is every bit as important as the physical part.
Discipline, that's her big key. Closing seconds of round number one. It's a championship. It's scheduled for 10. And this was a feeling out round for both Soumaya Anani and Dora Weber.
Feeling out round, but a round where most of the effective punching was Soumaya Anani. As we look into the corner of Dora Weber.
You're a little too far. You gotta get closer to her. Let your hands go. You gotta get busy, right? Right? That was the first round, but you know, you're in arm time. You gotta get a little busy. Bend those legs when you're inside. It's not better your legs. Come underneath with the body, right? You gotta rough her up a little bit, right? She looks like she's scared of you.
Yeah, she looks at her.
You're outpointing her. You're outpointing her big. Big, baby. All right, lead overhand right, or lead body shot, all right? Come on. Keep that chin down.
That was Barry Becker. He's in charge of several great fighters. Eva Young, who you saw earlier. Moira Ortega, who you'll see later. But this is his star, Soumaya Anani.
Chip Bolton out of Kansas City has one heck of a stable. You mentioned some of the fighters there. Look at Anani going to work on the body. And that's what she did to Christy Martin. Those two, they just went at it. I mean, they and you know, Christy's has been a tremendous fighter, too. And they just went at it. It was a war of attrition, and Anani won the war of attrition. I don't think there's any woman out there in the game who, in a war of attrition, battle of wills, will beat Soumaya Anani.
You got to be fit, and Dora Weber has trained very hard the last couple of months, lost some weight, really toned herself because she felt like she had a chance at knocking off the great Anani.
14-0, 6 KOs for Anani. 14-5-3, 7 KOs for Dora Weber. It's hard. A lot of people don't realize how, you know, long the women's game's been around. I mean, she's been around all for like 20 years, but the last 5 years, though, the game has really elevated to what we're seeing here tonight.
Anani's such a complex person, too. Today we were interviewing her. Smitty, you were doing the interview. And she started talking about the sacrifices, and she got to her son, and she became so emotional we had to stop the interview.
Yeah, she broke down and cried, but that's what I like about her. I like the fact that she displays different emotions. I think the great fighters, all the great fighters, you know, just demonstrate varying tides of emotion. Good body shot by Weber there. Big left hook, though, by Anani there, Dave.
Anani did have the answer, and I love the hand speed from both these women.
You can see the savvy of Dora Weber. You can see those years of experience.
You can see she doesn't mind eating the left jab to try to throw a big one. There's a good right hand that Weber got in at the end.
And Weber shouting, talking to Soumaya Anani. Of course, this is a rematch of a fight that Anani won via decision. But Weber gaining in confidence. However, I think losing the first couple of rounds.
When you lost, when you got it. You got to get hungry in there, bro, all right? Come on, this is your fight. Stay close to her. Listen, you jab, you got to move your head side to side, all right? Don't drop your jab, she's going over the top on you. She's going over the top on you.
Well, you see a nice chopping right there by Dora Weber, but a big left hook by Anani. And Weber comes right back and didn't bother. She shakes it off and keeps coming in.
Weber doesn't go back very easy, does she? She just keeps coming no matter what. It's scheduled for 10.
She's got to be in good shape.
Sandra Henderson is in Soumaya Anani's corner. Let's go down there.
Yes, I'm with Brian right now. You guys told Soumaya this is her fight. But Dora is a pretty crafty fighter. What does Soumaya need to do to keep control of this fight?
Well, we can't take anything away from Dora. She's showing us the things before she does it. If we keep our eyes open, we can see everything she's going to do.
She's given us a lot of opportunities to hit her.
So what's Samaya's game plan?
Condition them to play the point. We're in tremendous condition. We want to see if she's in condition. We're in great shape. That's the point right there. We're going to work up and down.
Well, we see she keeps going downstairs, upstairs.
Right, that's our whole game plan.
All right. Thank you, Brian. Good luck to you guys.
That was Brian Spicer, who works with Barry Becker in the Anani corner.
And they're talking about attrition, conditioning. Sumaya Anani can fight this way for 20 rounds if she has to. And they feel they'll take over the fight as the fight progresses.
And even though Weber has worked hard for this fight, she was actually a pound overweight at the weigh-in yesterday. Frankly, when you're 40, it's a lot tougher to go that kind of distance at this kind of a pace with someone who's 26.
And I'm 40 years old. You see where I'm at?
That's exactly what I'm saying.
This fight, I'm in great shape. You see where I'm at? I'm up here watching and talking. But I think that pressure, that attrition, that conditioning, that of Anani, that you see it taking over now, will eventually wear down Weber. Nice right hand, lead right by a very, as Cassandra called her, crafty Dora Weber. Look at the slipping, look at the movement.
Now there's no doubt that Dora Weber has an awful lot of skill. You can't fight for 23 years and not have a lot of skill. You wouldn't last that long, that's for sure.
And the reason you don't see many fights, 14-5 and 3-7 KOs, is because back then there weren't any women around to fight.
Think about going back to the 80s and 15-rounders, you know. She's seen about everything you can. Look at how calm and cool, though, Sumaya Anani is. You know, she is a very introspective person. Goes inside and concentrates, she says, on breathing, that most people don't utilize their lung capacity correctly. And that's why she does a lot of yoga and meditation.
She's also been in there against her idol and beaten her idol and Christy Martin, and that in and of itself elevated her physically and mentally. She knows she can conquer the best of them.
Well, and to show you the state of the game, she doesn't like to say this, but she'll admit that Martin might not have been the toughest opponent she's ever faced, which goes to show you where the game is going, the parity now that we will see at all levels of women's boxing.
Although I would have to say that Christy was the toughest opponent she's faced. It was a great fight. Christy, by the way, she called me from the Hall of Fame in Canastota last night. She'd like a rematch.
Could be arranged down the road. But Anani has to take care of business here.
And Weber's not making it easy. Look at the left jab. Left hook by Dora Weber. Just as you can tell a skilled male fighter with experience, you can see that Weber knows all the little subtleties inside the boxing ring. Nice uppercut by Weber.
Well, the interesting aspect here is I'm not sure anybody's really landed an effective blow midway through round four, and it's not for lack of effort. These two are very skilled at what they do.
Anani trying to set up the right hand. There it is to the body and into the head. Missed with the left hook.
And look at Dora Weber just avoid the leather.
But there's the right hand I'm talking about.
That one got in. The intensity for Anani picking up a bit.
And the patience of Anani, although she has a little trouble, she's patient, picking her shots. Look at the defensive skills of Weber, though. Despite the hands being down, she's got the left hand going out, moving, slipping. She's getting a little tired, though, already, and that's not a good sign.
A short left hand got in for Anani. The total aggressor, Sumaya Anani. And she won that round for sure.
And Anani did something very intelligent there. She's took a step back to create some room to punch. Let's look at some of the action. Weber had her moments too during that round. Using the left jab. And there's the left hook. Didn't do any damage. Speaking of hooks though, watch Anani's. As she backs Weber up.
Moves the
right hand, another left, and then a right, left, right. Good combination work by, you see her there, Soumaya Nani.
Yeah, Dorho Weppers.
Blowing a kiss to you, Dave.
Trying to promote the game at every opportunity. Yeah, she focuses so quickly. I mean, really and truly, she's an entertainer.
You notice Anani's style, her facial expressions, her movement doesn't waver. She's very consistent the entire fight.
The thing I've been impressed with is the way that Weber slips and moves, despite the fact she doesn't look as if she's that quick.
Well, she doesn't have the body of a gazelle, but no. She's got tremendous experience, and she knows how to use all of this ring and utilize all the talents that she's exhibited for 20 years inside the ring. That's a lot of years. Those little subtleties that are creating the situation where Anani can't set down and land the big shot.
You're right.
But that's okay because Anani's so patient.
Yeah, she is.
Look at that shotgun jab there.
That left jab did squeeze between the gloves of Weber.
Good left hook by Anani.
Moved away, didn't get hit, but yet she hasn't really delivered any kind of a blow that would cause a problem for Anani.
You know, I know folks want to see knockouts, but I tell you what, for women's boxing, as I said at the outset, this is a great display of talent and where the women's game. These are really skilled athletes.
I agree with you. I think this fight is evidence of the skill involved. Watch the quick hands and the ability to throw at angles by Anani, and then watch Weber with the ability to slip and move. But because Anani has been the aggressor, and because she's landed a couple of effective blows, she's winning this fight, or it appears to us. And that's the end of that round. And there is some respect between those two. You saw that there.
Anani's winning all the rounds. They're close rounds. But Anani's coming forward, landing the harder punches.
Have you
and
got,
I have her pitching a shutout.
You do.
All the time. He's throwing the punches wide. I get a little bit closer. A little bit closer for her. You would, yeah, a little bit your hand. Not one punch at a time. There's a picture in there. Come on. It's your fight, baby. Come on. She's respecting you. Yeah. All right? Yeah, so three, four punches in there, all right? Move your head. Don't drop the jab. She's going over the top. Don't drop the jab. Double the jab, but she will counter it. All right? Breathe. Come on. I want to go around.
Down.
I want to go around.
Down.
The word is counter more.
All right, I want to go around now. Come on.
Hard to counter somebody who's moving away so quickly, huh?
Styles make fights. These two match up well. Another great job by Avedon. Brian Allen of matching up the fighters. They battled to a decision before, and they're headed that way again. I like the movement of Anani. Moving, you know, just choppy little steps, setting up that stiff left jab that you'll see coming up here.
Nobody really hit anybody there.
Yep,
it was loud, but everything was on the arms.
Those shots on the arms hurt, though. Anani starting to set down on her punches a little bit more.
If the arms get weary, the theory goes they will drop. There's a good left hand by Anani.
You know, if a person has a great defense, rather than just not throw punches, even hitting the arms, you know, as you mentioned, is effective. Anani's pressure, though, is catching up, I think, slowly with Weber. She keeps coming forward. She's very methodical.
has four unanswered blows, not with a lot of steam, but jabs that have landed.
Anani doesn't waste many punches, does
nope.
he?
She wins every round close, you're absolutely correct.
Weber staggered by a shot. Nani's working her over here on.
Yeah, she is, but I'm not sure Weber's really in any kind of trouble.
I think she is.
That's the end of the round. And I don't know if there was words exchanged, but certainly some intense glances as Barry Becker and Brian Spicer go to work.
She comes forward. She really worked over Weber at the end of that round. Coming in, jab, right hand misses, but look at the effect of aggression on the ropes, pounding away. Sumaya Nani slips a punch, lands a left hook, misses with a left hook, but throwing, not a lot landed.
You know, you may be right. That left hook might have really bothered her. I'm not so sure. She's just not tired. And remember, she's 40 now. Age could be a factor here, is Anani? Goes to work in the middle of the ring.
Look at the intensity, though.
Look at that left jab.
Anani just doesn't waver, Dave. I mean, it's the same thing. And Christy Martin found this out.
It's relentless.
It is. It may not look relentless because she does it so calculated and so cool and so calm, but it's relentless.
Oh, a good left hand, an answer from Weber, but she ate two punches before she got that one in.
Oh, I like the way she turned her body there and threw that jab. Anani really knows how to use the left jab. I don't know if the mouthpiece came out of Anani or what, but I thought I saw something coming. Good uppercut by Anani and a right hand.
The jab followed, and here she goes. She's clearly the aggressor. She clearly has this one in control. Anani's corner told her she could knock her out as she works with that left hand.
Weber in some trouble again. She's talking. That's usually a sign that means you're hurt. Look at her mouth, Dave.
I always thought the taunting when you were getting knocked to smithereens was funny. It's a sign of frustration.
Weber's
so tired. Did you see that? And there's a good left hand right to the chin.
She's not going to make it through many more rounds. She keeps getting hit like this with that mouth wide open. Good body work by Sumaya. Coming right in with a body shot. She's pummeling Weber.
And Nani in control.
Complete control.
IFBA Junior Welterweight Championship.
Complete control, Dave, to the body, to the head. You look at the corner of Dora Weber there. We'll see what they're going to say, Dora. Here's some of the action. Look at Anani. Focused, looking for her shots, picking her shots. They're short, they're accurate, they're powerful, and they're very effective.
She is so calm in her approach, Smitty.
You can see the fatigue on the face of Dora Weber.
Classic example of trying to throw a left hand or a right hand quickly, but the body just not able to do it.
I think that Anani can get a stoppage here if she really comes out aggressive these next two rounds. I really think she can get a stoppage. She doesn't go for the knockout, but she can get one here tonight.
Half the time she's won, she's knocked folks out. 14-0 with 7 KOs. 6 minutes away from another win over Dora Weber.
Weber has 7 KOs, but you just can't hurt Sumaya Anani. Christy Martin couldn't do it. Anani's going for that knockout, I think, too.
Good left hand. staggered Weber.
These are very accurate hard punches. Look at that shotgun jab again there.
A body punch by Weber. It doesn't stop Anani at all. She's calculated now. That right hand just missed, but she still paws her way back toward the corner with it.
Experience, Dave.
And some incredible hearts. She's gotten knocked the last couple of rounds, Smitty. She just doesn't want to quit. There's a good combination by Anani. And Weber just can't find the target at all. She's so tired. Just fighting on instinct alone, has really very little left.
Utilize all of that experience to stay in this fight.
And Anani, two rounds away from her 15th win against no defeats. And the only way that Weber could win would be with a knockout, and we don't think that'll happen. Here is again Brian Spicer.
Give up on the guy. Two rounds, all right? Full combination. Put 3-4 punch inside, all right? Put a lot of water on it. Put water on her face. On her face. All right. Breathe. All right? Breathe again. Come on. Come on. You got this. Yours. Come on. All right? You heard a few times, then you stop punching. Come on.
You heard the words, you've heard her a couple of times. Can you remember Anani being hurt in this fight?
I can't remember Anani really being hurt that seriously in any fight I've seen her. And I did her fight with Martin, and I was at the Denise Moraitis fight. Mouthpiece, they're looking for the Dora Weber, looking for that mouthpiece, which is good. That buys her a few more seconds at age 40.
Could be calculated. You know, experience brings lots of tricks.
Same way as in round one.
Well, you watch Anani, and you watch her tactics and her execution. She has a game plan. She never varies from it. Well, let's go down ringside to Cassandra Henderson.
Guys, what's so interesting about Samaya is that she is a boxer brawler, and a lot of fighters don't really know what to expect from her. And tonight, she came out with a lot of both. Now, I've been looking at these body shots she's been throwing all night long, and they have been doing a lot of damage to Dora. I mean, she's barely breathing up here. She's barely hanging on, and I've been looking for that KO, but she is hanging on.
So much heart that Dora Weber has, you almost suspect she's going to hang on.
I agree with you, Cassandra. The great body work by Anani, but you have to give a lot of credit to Weber for, you know, hanging in there. I thought she looked out of it a couple rounds ago, but she's really hung in there again. You can attribute that to those 20 years inside the ring and national audience, pay-per-view audience tonight. She's a pioneer in this game, and she's not going to go out easy, if at all.
Right. And while that era, the Weber era, may be coming to a close, the Anani legend will continue to grow. And I got to ask you point blank, you've seen them all.
Weber,
you've seen Lucia Riker. They want to see her go down. I'm telling you, Weber's not going down. They're going to try to fight back. That's heart. And that's the end of round number 9. And the question to you is, Anani the best in the game right now?
I think so. The victory over Christy Martin, the victory over Denise Moraitis. Lucia Riker, despite looking great and fighting great at times, when she fights, has been very inactive. There have been all kinds. Nani's the best, and here's an example why. You see the heads come together there. That happened a lot against Christy Martin, and those dreadlocks of Anani hurt. They're not purposeful, but the style of Anani with that head coming in forward, he almost uses it as a battering ram. A lot of fighters have complained about that. Certainly not on purpose, in my opinion.
Some abrasions on the cheek under the left eye of Dora Weber. I give her a lot of credit. She's tired, yet she comes out. And this is the championship round, the final round.
And you know what? Although some of the rounds have been close, you could pretty much call this a shutout with Soumaya Anani.
Very impressive indeed.
Styles make fights. I guess these two could probably fight until Weber's 50. And same kind of fight. Anani really battering her, though, all
she
across
is.
The ring.
Keeps coming forward, throws punches from all different angles. She is complete. Skilled. Calm, smart. She's the total package, and that's why she's number one in the world.
We're in the 10th round of a fight where Anani is throwing a lot of punches, and you see the same speed, the same leverage, the same power.
Good right hand, an uppercut that time.
Big left hook by Anani.
You know, it's a cliche when you sell, when you talk about a precise, skilled surgeon in the ring, but that's the kind of showing we've seen from Anani tonight.
Well, it's been a dissection, and then you can see the wear and tear on the face of Dora Weber.
And I can't remember Anani really getting hit.
She's really improved her defensive skills the last few fights after the Martin fight. I think that's a product of confidence now. She's becoming a complete fighter. That's bad news for the rest of the women because she's getting better. And she's already unbeaten.
There were some who really thought Anani would fall to Weber tonight because they didn't think Weber was in shape the first time they fought. But Anani is getting better and better. And that's it. A tremendous showing by Soumaya Anani. Is she 15-0? We think so. We'll find out for sure in just a minute.
Hey,
you got that a shutout, don't you?
Might be a virtual shutout. I can see this 190 the, scoring.
The island girl spent some time in Jamaica, came back to start the fight. That's how she got the nickname. But really, she was born in Minneapolis, lives in Kansas City, Missouri, and is of Iranian descent.
And I'm not taking anything away from Dora Weber. You see her there backing up because she, you know, has been a real crafty veteran for a long time.
So this one's about in the books. Let's get the official word and go ringside, or inside the ring, I should say, to Danny Valdivia.
Ladies and gentlemen, all three judges agree with the same score, 97-93. All in favor of the winner by unanimous decision, and new IFBA Continental Junior Welterweight Champion, Soumaya Anani. Presenting the championship belt to the winner, the commissioner of the IFBA.
97-93, maybe closer than we had expected.
And you see Shelley Williams, the commissioner there, giving her the belt. One of many, I think, Anani will have before it's all over. You see the unblemished record, the 7 KOs.
And now 15-0. And this was impressive because Dora Weber is one skilled customer, I gotta tell you.
You know, Anani's emotions may waver, you know, in between fights and around fights, but not during fights.
And Dora Weber says, I'll be back. Don't worry about it, I'll be back. In the meantime, Anani's crowned a champion, but it's time.